Maintaining a working bibliography. Dear guys, while you are doing your research work, you must be exploring various sources for the sake of literature review. You are required to go through a lot of books, a lot of sources, journal articles, web pages, directories, so many published and unpublished sources, right? So while managing all that information, you are required to keep record of the sources, right? And how would you maintain a working bibliography, and how would you keep the record of everything you are going through for the sake of your research? So in this session, we are going to talk about particular tips which are important for researchers, okay? So effective researchers are always good record keepers, remember? So you are required to be a good record keeper, okay? And then record keeping is really important, because if you're not keeping record of your sources, then you may be praying to unintentional plagiarism. And as academics, we are required to, as researchers, we are required to, take care of such academic offenses like plagiarism, because plagiarism is something which is unacceptable. And as the result of plagiarism, you may be losing your degree, you may be losing your job, or you may be losing your position, right? So we must be very careful about plagiarism, okay? So record working bibliography. So whatever you are going through as a source for your literature review, you must be keeping record of that. And then there are systematic ways to manage, your record. And the keeping track of your sources by keeping 3 copies of every source. And how would you do that? There are possibilities. You can email, the soft source to your own account, or like keeping a record of that. Okay. So email that information which you are going through for the sake of record. And then you must be saving it as well, on your machine, on your laptop or computer, or in your USB. So you are saving that. And the third is that you are taking prints of that as well. So the print copy is also there. In other words, you are actually maintaining the record of your sources, which you are using in your research literature review through 3 ways, right? So emailing, and then saving either in hard form or in soft form, and then printing it, right? So these are the ways you would be keeping record of it, and you must be keeping track record of all source materials, right? And then you are highlighting the key passages for your future use, right? And then you may be using coloring or color coding, right? So these are the points which would help you out avoiding plagiarism and the chances of unintentional plagiarism, because unintentionally we may be committing plagiarism. So if you are keeping record of everything and you would be getting back to them in future while finalizing your research work, research studies, or your thesis, then you can avoid plagiarism as well as unintentional plagiarism, right? So let me now just take you to one example of, this annotated bibliography, right? There is the reference given on the top of this slide, right? Gonslev's Chris, and the title is given in the quotation marks, Wasting Away on the Web. eWeek.com is the source. Ziff Davis Enterprise Holdings are the publishers, and the date is 8 August 2005, Web 16 February 2009, right? So you see the date of publication, and then the date of access, that how, when did you as a researcher access it, right? So this is annotated bibliography, and you see that they summarize the source. So the source is summarized. In this editorial, Gonslaves considers the implications of several surveys, including one in which 61% of respondents said that their companies have the right to spy on them, right? So that is actually the the focus and the source is summarized. The annotation of the source should be between 3 and 7 sentences, right? So remember that. Then the author agrees with this majority, claiming that it's fine if his company chooses to monitor him as long as the company discloses its monitoring practices. He argues that the days of internet freedom at work are justifiably finished, adding that he would prefer not to know the extent of the surveillance. Gonslaves writes for eweek.com, a publication focused on technology products, right? So you see, you know, the quotations are used sparingly, but quotation marks around any words from the source, they are given. So if you are quoting directly from the source, they are in the quotation marks, right? And then interpret the relationship between this source and others in your bibliography. So now you would connect it with that. He presents himself as an employee who is comfortable with being monitored, but his job may be a source of bias. This editorial contradicts some of my other sources, which claim that employees want to know and should know all the details of their company's monitoring procedures. So this is the author's evaluation or reflection about this source, right? So this is called annotated bibliography. When you are maintaining a bibliography with the summary of the source, using quotations for direct quotations, and then you are providing your own evaluation as well, right? So this is one way we should maintain for annotated bibliography. And then the information which is required to be taken care of for any source you are using is also really important. And on this slide, I'm giving you some tips. If it's a book, then the authors, the title and the subtitles, right? The edition, if it is first edition or seventh edition or whatever is the number of edition, then publication information, the city of publication, who published it, and the date of publication, right? Or the year of publication most of the time for APA style, okay? For periodical articles, all authors of the article, right? Title and subtitle of the article, title of the magazine, journal or newspaper which published it, then the date, volume, issue, and page numbers. So that is for a periodical article. If the periodical article is retrieved from a database, then you are required to mention some more detail like name of the database and an item number if available, name of the subscription service, URL of the subscription service, accession number or other number assigned by the database, digital object identifier. Remember, this is DOI is really important if there is one. And then the date you retrieved the source. So your retrieval date is also important for any source which you are retrieving from a database, right? So these are the points which are to be there, which are to be maintained for record. For a web source, including visuals, if you are taking any visual, any image from the web page, then all authors, editors, or creators of the source, editor or compiler, who compiled it, then title and the subtitle, title of the site, publication information, page or paragraph number, date of online publication, sponsor of the site, date you accessed the source. So the date of publication is different than your retrieval, okay? And then the site's URL. So these are the tips which are important for maintaining a working bibliography while doing your research work.